There's no guarantee that any memory is accurate. And what we want to do, that even under hypnosis, it may not be accurate. Sometimes when information we get, we need to get other people to support it. If you choose not to use hypnosis, that's okay. There's no problem. But maybe you can, and you choose not to.
Say what you don't say, doctor.
Would you like to use it?
What?
Hypnosis. No, then we won't use it. Maybe you could then just tell me what you saw. And we're not going to use hypnosis, we're just going to talk. Okay? Maybe you could tell me what you saw on the night you came in on January 13th, 1998. Just describe to me what you saw.
The same thing I told the police and no more, no less. This is what I saw.
Please.
I went up on the fourth floor at Prince George's Hospital. When I got up there, it was 7:30. And I cleaned up two bathrooms down the hallway. And I went to the desk down on the other side, down the hallway. And I heard the lady screaming twice. And I walked past the desk. I went to the, down the hallway to past the fire room to that door right there. I saw the lady laying on the floor. The man's hand was around her neck. Looked like around her neck, right here. I thought the man was helping her. Seemed like he wasn't helping her, he was hurting her. When I got there, I guess God stopped me in my tracks. I thought he was helping her, still he helping her, he was killing her. I didn't realize that, cause I like to be by myself, right? And when somebody stay by themselves all the time, you don't realize a heap of things going on with people, right? So I stopped there. I stood there for about 5 minutes. Then when I was going back down the hallway past the fire room, I started to pick the telephone up twice. Some of them telling me, and then you better get out of there. I got out. Before I got out of there, the man had on a white lab jacket, on his knees, kneeling down. The side of his face was black. That's all I saw. The lady was laying on the floor straight up there like this. And, I went back in the hallway. I went, got through cleaning the two bathrooms. I went downstairs on K2. There were two more people up there in that room. I didn't see them right away. He was up there cleaning. Yeah, that's all I saw. It upset me real bad when I somebody paid over here and said the lady was laying on the floor with a blouse up over her head, blood was coming out. That scared me. That's all I saw, and that's all I remember.
Gone through a lot.
And then, see, I have to go back up on the floor now. They put me back up there to clean the bathroom. And when I go up there, maybe a little nervous going up there. like I hear some all the time. I know people's up there with me, like the security guards and stuff, but it's still not down there by the bathroom and by them steps down there. Seems like I hear noises. It's all that scares me.
Cost a lot of
them. I think I'm going to be going through that though. Because I ain't never seen nothing like that before. That's how come I want to take my... See, can I tell you something, doctor? See, when I go home at night, I pray, but I find myself crying. See, I was trying to talk to my boss not to let me go up on that floor. You don't have my feelings inside. My feelings inside make me sometimes want to make me break down.
And a lot of times you keep these things inside.
And sometimes I can keep them inside because I don't have nobody to talk to most of the time. I guess I'm a mother. I learned how to do that. Try to act strong for my kids.
You have that mother instinct to try and take care of children first.
Kids come first, grandkids come first. Worry about them all the time. What no happened to them. I guess I'm a person. Been through a whole lot.